Vitamin D is one of the most prevalent nutrient deficiencies across the globe. This systemic review from March 2023 showed that vitamin D deficiency remained widespread from 2000 to 2022. If you do take vitamin D supplements, there is a high chance you're doing it incorrectly. And this would not only make the supplement ineffective, but it could also lead to potential health risks. My name is Claudia, I'm a 45-year-old holistic nutrition coach with a master's in human nutrition and dietetics, and help busy women in the 40s to take control of their health. Vitamin D is crucial for numerous bodily functions and overall health. Reduces the risk of multiple sclerosis, decreases the chances of heart disease, supports immune health, regulates mood and reduces depression, improves fatigue, improves inflammation, cardiovascular risk, and anxiety, improves pain and sleep. And get this, individuals with high levels of vitamin D often live longer and healthier lives. Vitamin D is also essential for the regulation of calcium and phosphorus absorption. The study from March 2023 followed a diverse group of over 12,000 people to assess the long-term effects of vitamin D supplementation on dementia. Researchers reported a 40% reduction in dementia risk over 10 years among those supplementing with vitamin D, particularly in older women, likely due to the interplay with the declining estrogen, which activates vitamin D. Of course, Mother Nature has gifted us with foods containing vitamin D, but I have to say, she has been a bit stingy. Cod liver oil contains the highest amount of vitamin D, with just one tablespoon, greatly exceeding the daily recommended intake. Next, we have rainbow trout, salmon, and this may be a bit surprising, but mushrooms also contain vitamin D. Fortified foods such as various milks and cereals also provide vitamin D, though in smaller quantities. Sardines, eggs, beef liver, and tuna are additional sources, although with less amounts. If only few foods provide adequate vitamin D, does it mean that we should turn to supplements? Not necessarily, but it depends on the season and our lifestyle. The sun is the most natural source of vitamin D, with proper skin exposure. 15 to 20 minutes of exposure for 60% of our skin daily can be sufficient for vitamin D production, in particular for the active form D3. Keep in mind that exposing only our face, especially if wearing sunscreen, won't help much. Make sure though you don't expose your skin to harsh sun and avoid the hottest hours of the day. Best would be at sunrise and sunset. This way you will also help your body activate and shut down melatonin, which will help to follow a natural circadian rhythm. There are factors though that can make it harder to get enough vitamin D from the sun. Among those factors we have, for example, if you live in an area with high pollution, if you spend most of your time indoors, if you live in a big city where buildings block sunlight, or if you have darker skin. The higher the levels of melanin, the less vitamin D your skin can absorb. Vitamin D is fat soluble, so it's recommended to get a form of supplement that uses fat as a carrier. Liquid vitamin D tends to be better absorbed than other types of vitamin D. This is the one I use, and I just need to put some drops under my tongue. I take it in the morning before my breakfast. When buying vitamin D, make sure to buy the active form D3 rather than D2. Supplements are measured in international units, and it's advisable to take between 1,000 and 2,000 IU daily. The supplement I take contains 500 IU per drop, so I take 3 drops daily during the colder months of the year. When taking vitamin D supplements, it's recommended to take it with vitamin K2. Vitamin K2 plays a crucial role in directing calcium from our bloodstream to our bones, where it's actually essential. A modest amount of vitamin K2, about 100 micrograms, is sufficient for maintaining optimal levels. Many supplements come with both vitamin D3 and K2 together. Now, even more important, the vitamin K2 is supplementing magnesium, especially when taking vitamin D in higher doses. You see, magnesium is needed to help convert more basic forms of vitamin D to more advanced forms that are functional in our body. So the more vitamin D we need to make, the more magnesium we need. What we want to avoid, and that's what would make taking vitamin D incorrectly, is to have the vitamin D depleting our magnesium levels, with the relative health consequences, and then wonder why the vitamin D we are taking is not helping. Our vitamin D levels fluctuate during the years, and that's why it's recommended to check our levels a couple of times a year. I remember once a doctor told me that I shouldn't test it because its value is always changing. Well, obviously, I never went back to see him. I usually check my levels at the end of summer to have an idea how much to supplement during the colder months, and then I check it again at the beginning of spring to see if the supplements did their job. The standard government's recommendation for vitamin levels are pretty low, suggesting 30 nanograms per milliliter is normal, and only categorizing levels in the 20s as deficient. However, many healthcare providers nowadays advocate for maintaining levels between 100 and 150 nanograms per milliliter. Natural vitamin D production from sun exposure or from food ingestion would never cause toxicity, as our body is smart enough to regulate its production. Vitamin D supplements, on the other hand, are man-made substances that could be toxic by increasing calcium levels in our blood, causing a variety of health issues, such as nausea, apathy, vomiting, abdominal pain, dehydration, confusion, and increased thirst. If you notice any symptoms when taking vitamin D, make sure to report it to your doctor and change your dosage. As usual, it's always recommended to consult with your doctor when taking supplements. Also, whenever we make changes in our diet, supplements, and lifestyle, it's important to make them one at a time. For example, don't start taking multiple supplements at the same time. Give it at least a week to see how your body reacts and make any adjustments you might need. Now, circling back to magnesium supplements, if you're not sure which time is best for you, check out this video next, where I help you make an informed decision. If you're new to my channel and want to take control of your health, make sure you subscribe right here to watch new videos every Wednesday. If you need personalized help to improve your health, you can work with me by using the link in the description box. Thanks so much for tuning in, e ci vediamo al prossimo video. Ciao!